Hello friends, this is Suresh Kumar Paswan, Assistant Professor in GSITS Indore. In today's class, we are going to carry out the particle size reduction using ball mill. The speed of the ball mill, it plays very crucial role. Like in ball mill, what happens, we are using metallic ball or ceramic balls of round shape. And these balls, we used to have in different size because if we are taking a single size ball or bigger size ball, there will be a void space between them, and that space will be a problem because the particle it will get inside those void space and the particle size reduction will not take place. So we used to have a different size of ball in the ball mill, and the speed of the ball, it also plays very important. So when we talk about slow speed, what will happen? This ball, it will lift to a certain height and it will slide down. So what will happen here? The particle size reduction will not be proper because only accretion process is taking place. And when we talk about very high speed, if this ball mill is rotating in very high speed, what will happen? This ball, it will get stuck to the surface of this mill and it will rotate with the ball mill. And there will and we don't have any kind of sliding, or we don't have any kind of impact in this kind of. And we talk about critical speed, the ball, it will lift to a certain height and it will get down, and it will collide, and it will both the process of impact and attrition will take over here, because if it is sliding, attrition will take place, and if it is lifting and it is falling down, the impact process will take place. Of course, starting the particle size reduction of the granules, we have to perform the size analysis of these granules. So how we are going to get the size analysis? We are using the sieve shaker, and these are the different size of meshes. So starting from this is the coarse mesh. The size of this particular mesh is 20. Then this is 30 number mesh. This one is 40 number mesh. This one is 60 number. One is 80 number. This one is 100 number mesh. This one is 200 number mesh, and this one is a pan which has to be kept in the bottom. So we will start this experiment of particle size distribution. Okay, so what we are doing?
Before milling, we are going to perform this size distribution studies, for which we are taking 30 gram of powder and transferring it, and we will transfer it into the sieve shaker apparatus. Now we are starting the apparatus for 5 minutes.
And this one is time.
Now we are going to stop this and check the amount of heat retained on each stage.
Sieve number?
Sieve number 20. Weight 0.66 grams. Weight 9.41 grams. Number 40. 14.55 grams. Sieve number 60. 4.9 grams. Sieve number 80. 0.37 grams. Sieve number 100. There is nothing. And the pan is empty.
So you can see the quantity, and you can write it down. You can total it, and few quantity of the powder, they would have stick to the sieve, as you can see here. So the exact quantity what we have taken, that was 30 gram, you cannot find it out. So you can sum total these value, and you can take it the total quantity of powder taken. Okay, you can sum total this one, and we can take the ball. So you can see the total quantity, it is 29 gram. So 1 gram wastage or the material, it has stick to the sieves. So the quantity of the powder which has to be filled in this ball mill, that will depend upon the volume of this ball mill. The height which we have found out of this ball mill, that was 10 centimeter, and the diameter which we have found out, that is 12 centimeter. Okay. And that will be equivalent to 1.13 liter. The maximum volume which we can fill of this ball mill, that will be equivalent to nearly about 565 ml. So the 50% only we are going to fill it, and in this 50%, 565 ml, we have to fill the ball and the powder.
Now we are going to determine the density of powder that we are going to feed in the ball mill. For that we have taken a 30 grams, that is a known amount of powder, which we are going to transfer in the measuring cylinder, from which we will get the volume of that powder, and from that volume we will calculate the density of the powder, and the formula for which is mass upon volume. As we have transferred the total 30 grams of powder in the measuring cylinder, and its volume is approximately 78 ml.
So the quantity of powder what we have to take into the ball mill, that is very important, and so we have some calculation for that one. So we have found out the density of the powder, the density of the powder which we have calculated, the mass what we have got, that was 30 gram, and the volume, that was 70 ml that we have taken out, and so the density will be 0.384. So now what we have found out, that the volume was 1.135 liter, and the 50% of that will be a void volume that we have to keep it empty, and the fill volume in which the ball will be there and the powder will be there. So that is, that volume is nearly about 565 ml or cubic centimeter, you can say. So what we are doing, we are taking 50%, the quantity what we have to fill is 50% ball will take and 50% powder we are going to take. So if we take that one, so nearly about 280, that we have rounded up, that is 280 cubic centimeter we have to fill, and then we have to calculate how much quantity of powder we are going to take. So for that we have calculated the thing. So 280, that is the volume cubic centimeter, into the density, that is 0.384, that is of density of powder. So what we are going to get, that is 107.52 gram. We have rounded up, so that value we are going to take 100 gram. So the powder what we are going to take into the ball mill is 100 gram of powder.
Now we are going to determine the density of the balls. As we know, we use balls of different size in ball mill for proper size reduction. Here the same, the size of these balls is varies. We will do what, we will take a fixed amount of the total balls we are going to weigh, and which we are going to transfer in the measuring cylinder, in which we have taken a water of 100 ml volume. This method is known as water displacement method. As the balls are of different size, so we are going to use this method, because of their variable size we cannot determine the exact density. So we will transfer these balls in the measuring cylinder. When we will put all the balls in this, the level of water will increase from 100 ml to a certain volume, and that will be the final volume. And when we will subtract the final volume and initial volume, we will get the exact volume of balls. And using this volume and weight, we will calculate the density. The volume of water level raised is up to 215 ml. So this is the final volume of water. Now we will immediately remove the water from the ball. Now we have to wipe the balls dry.
So now we have to calculate the quantity of balls which we have to use in this ball mill. and for that we have determined the density of the ball. The quantity of ball what we have to use in the ball mill is 1.3 kg.
The powder that is approximately, that is 100 grams. And here are the 1.3 kg balls that we are going to use for that. And now we are going to close the lid of this chamber. Now we are attaching the tumbler into the apparatus. Now we are going to start the apparatus for milling. As we all know, speed is very important in this, so we are going to keep it at a critical speed, where the balls go at the upside down and then fall for the impact process of size reduction. For half an hour, we are going to keep it.
So friends, you think that the process has been started and it will continue for nearly half an hour, and the speed is very critical in this equipment. The speed should be as such that the ball should move to the top and it should fall down so that the impact mechanism will take place and the calibration will take place. So we'll copy for half an hour and then we'll stop the process.
Half an hour is being completed and now we will stop this and remove it out. Removing the balls and powder from this.
Now we are going to separate the balls and the powder by using sieves.
Now we will determine the particle size distribution of this milled powder. For that we are taking 30 gram of this powder. And we will close the lid for it. The same for the 5 minutes we will do operate this. As 5 minutes are over, we are going to stop this and check the sieves. Sieve number 20,
2.2 grams.
Sieve number 30,
2.24 grams.
Sieve number 40, 8.5 grams. Sieve number 60, is 20 grams. Sieve number 80, 1 gram. Sieve number 100, 0.2 grams. Sieve number 120, 0, as it is nothing. Same with sieve number 200, this is also clean. And the pan is empty.
Okay. These are the size distribution after milling.